You're sure Miss Lucy is no worse?
I'm afraid she's just the same, sir. Make yourself comfortable. Dr. Seward should be along any minute.
What is it? Why have you sent for me?
I told you in my why, my dear boy, that there was nothing new.
You said don't worry. No change but to come at once.
And you lost no time.
Jumped in the car and burned up the road from London. Doctor, surely there must be something more we can do for Lucy. I'd give my life gladly if it would save her.
I'm sure you would, my boy. You love her with the warm blood of youth. But don't forget, I love my daughter too. She's all I have left. Now, you must see that nothing medical science can suggest has been left undone.
Medical science couldn't do much for Mina. Poor Mina.
Yes, Mina. She died after these same incredible symptoms that my Lucy has developed.
My Lucy, too.
Our Lucy, then.
Good God! What was that?
Only a patient of mine, Mr. Renfield.
But you never keep violent patients here in your sanatorium. Lucy mustn't be compelled to listen to raving madmen.
I quite agree, and I'm going to have him sent away. Until just lately, he was always quiet. I'll be sorry to lose him.
What?
An unusual case. Zoophagus.
What's that?
A life-eating maniac.
What?
He thinks that by absorbing lives, he can prolong his own life.
Good Lord!
He catches flies and eats them. And then by way of change, he feeds the flies to the spiders, fattens them up, and then he eats the spiders.
Oh, disgusting! But tell me about Lucy. Why have you sent for me?
Yesterday, I wired to Holland for my old friend, Professor Van Helsing. He'll be here soon. The car's just gone down to the station to him. I'm going to turn Lucy's case over to him.
Another specialist on anemia?
No, whatever this may be, it's not anemia. And this man, who speaks a dozen languages, knows more about mysterious diseases than anyone alive.
Heaven knows, mysterious enough, but surely the symptoms are clear.
So were Mina's, perfectly clear. Oh, there they are, at it again. We've every dawn for miles around. We've heard that chorus every night since Mina first fell ill.
When I was traveling in Russia, and the dogs in the village barked like that, the natives used to say wolves were prowling about.
Well, I hardly think you'll find wolves prowling around early, 20 miles from London.
Yet, your old house might be in the wilderness. Nothing in sight except that place Carfax, which Count Dracula has taken.
Your friend the Count came in again last evening.
He's no friend of mine.
Well, don't say that. He knows that you and I have given our blood for Mina as well as for Lucy. And he's offered to undergo transfusion himself if we need another volunteer.
That was decent of him. Perhaps I misjudged him.
He seems genuinely interested in Lucy. If he were a young man, I think...
What?
But his whole attitude shows it isn't that. We need sympathy in this house, John, and I'm grateful for it.
So am I. Anyone who offers to help Lucy can have anything I've got.
Well, I think he does help Lucy. She always seems cheered up whenever he comes.
That's all fine. May I go to Lucy now?
We'll go together. Oh, that must be Van Helsing. You go ahead, I'll come presently.
Professor Van Helsing, sir.
My dear Van Helsing, I can never repay you for this.
Oh, were a patient of yours instead of your daughter, I would have come. You once granted me a service.
Oh, no need to speak of that. You'd have done the same for me.
Let me give you something to eat.
No, I dined on the boat train. I do not waste time when there is work to do.
Ah, Van Helsing, I leaned on you before you've been 2 minutes in my house.
You wrote of your daughter's symptoms. Tell me more of the other young lady, the one who died. Mm.
Poor Mina Weston. She was a girl just Lucy's age. They were inseparable. She was on a visit here when she fell ill. As I wrote you, she just grew pale and weak. Day by day, she wasted away. But there were no anemic symptoms, and her blood was normal when analyzed.
You said you performed transfusion.
Yes, Sir William Briggs ordered that. Lucy herself, as well as her fiancé, John Harker, gave their blood as well.
So three transfusions. And the effect?
Well, she rallied after each one. The color returned to her cheek. But the next morning, she'd be pale and weak again. She complained of bad dreams. 10 days ago, we found her in a stupor from which nothing could rouse her. She died.
And the other symptoms?
Well, none. Oh, except for those two marks on her throat that I wrote you about.
Could you perhaps brought me in so quickly? What were they like?
Oh, just two little white dots with red centers. We decided she must have run a safety pin through the skin of her throat, trying in her delirium to fasten a scarf or...
And your daughter's symptoms are the same?
Oh, precisely. She, too, complains of bad dreams. Van Helsing, you've lived in the tropics. May this not be something alien to our medical experience in England?
It may indeed, my friend. Who is this man?
Benfield!
Sit!
Did you hear us talking?
Words, blah, blah, blah.
Come, Benfield. You know you mustn't wander around like this. How did you get out of your room?
Wouldn't you like to know?
How are the flies, Renfield? Mr. Renfield makes a hobby out of eating flies. Sometimes you eat spiders, too, don't you, Renfield?
Will you walk into my parlor, said the spider to the fly. Excuse me, Doctor, you haven't introduced me to more friends.
Oh, come, come, Renfield. Humor him. Bring the attendants at once.
Yes, sir.
Oh, very well. Professor Van Helsing, Mr. Renfield, a patient of mine.
Ah! Who does not know Van Helsing? Your works are investigating certain obscure diseases. Not altogether unconnected with forces and powers that the ignorant herd do not believe exist, has won you the position that posterity will recognize.
Butterworth, you've let your patient out of his room again.
Oh, God, myself. I locked the door and I've got the keys.
But this is the second time. Only last night you let him escape, and he tried to break into Count Dracula's house across the grounds.
Well, he didn't get out the door this window this time, sir, and has dropped it 30 feet out the windows.
He's just a blooming eel. Eel, you come with me.
Redfield, if this happens again, you will get no more sugar to spread out for your flies.
What do I care for flies now? Flies. Flies are the poor things.
And the spiders.
Professor Van tell me why that one great spider lived for centuries in the tower of the old Spanish church. And he grew and he grew, but he didn't eat. He drank. And he drank. He would come down and drink the oil from all the church lamps.
Butterworth.
Whoa, Dr. Sawyer, send me away. Now, tonight, in a straight waistcoat. Chain me so I can't escape. This is a sanatorium, not a lunatic asylum. This is no place for me. My cries will disturb Miss Lucy, who is ill. Your daughter will have bad dreams, Dr. Sawyer. Bad dreams.
We'll see about all this in the morning.
Why are you so anxious to go?
I'll tell you, not that fool Seward. He wouldn't understand. But you.
What was that?
No. I wasn't going to say anything.
What was that?
Oh, it was a bat, gentlemen. Only a bat. You know that in some islands of the eastern seas, there are bats which hang from trees. And when the heat is stifling and the sailors sleep on the deck in those harbors, in the morning, they are found dead. Quite. Even as Miss Mina was.
What do you know about Miss Mina? Take him away.
No, please. Why are you so anxious to be moved from here?
Save my soul.
Yes.
Or you'll get nothing more out of me than that. And I'm not sure I hadn't rather stay. After all, what is my soul good for? Is not what I am to receive worth the loss of my soul?
What's got him thinking about souls? Have you the souls of those flies and spiders on your conscience?
I forbid you to plague me about souls. I don't want their souls. All I want is their life. The blood is the life.
So?
That's in the Bible. What use do I have of souls? I can't eat them or
drink.
You know too much to live in her state! Go! Please, I'll go quiet. Mr. Butterworth, I'll go quiet. Send me away. I asked you to before, Dr. Seward, and you wouldn't. If you don't, you will have to answer for my soul before the judgment seat of God. Okay.
My friend, you are not hurt.
No.
My deepest apologies. You'll think my place shockingly bad. What was your herb that excited it?
Wolfsbane.
Wolfsbane? What's that?
I thought
I knew everything in the pharmacopoeia.
A type of erythrite. Pliny the Elder mentions the plant. It's only found in the wilds of central Russia.
Well, why did you bring it with you?
Oh, it is a form of preventive medicine.
Well, I never heard of it.
Seward, I want you to have that lunatic securely watched.
Well, anything you say, Doctor, but it's my daughter I want you to look after first.
I want to keep this man under observation.
Well, an interesting maniac, no doubt, but surely you'll see my daughter.
I must see the records of his case.
But Doctor!
Do you think I have forgotten why I am here?
Forgive me. Of course you may see my records. But I don't understand why you're so curious about Renfield. In your vast experience, you must have seen many lunatics and maniacs.
Thought they were here.
John, do you think this new man will be any better than the others?
I'm sure he will. And anyway, now that I'm back, I'm going to stay here until you get over this thing.
But can you? You're working town.
You come first.
I don't think you better stay, John. Sometimes I feel that I want to be alone.
Lucy, you love me, don't you?
Yes, John, with all my soul.
As soon as you're well, I'm going to take you away. We'll be married next month. We won't wait till June. We'll stretch that honeymoon month to 3, and the house will be ready by July.
Oh, John, you think we could?
Of course. Why not? My mother wanted us to wait, but she'll understand, and I want to get you away. Why do you shrink away from me when I go to kiss you, and you're so cold now?
Forgive me, darling. I'm yours. Oh, John, I'm tired. So tired.
Lucy, I'd like you to meet my old friend, Professor Van Helsing.
My dear Miss Seward, you don't remember old Van Helsing. I remember you when you were a little girl so high. And now what charm, what beauty. A little pale, perhaps, but we will bring the roses back to the cheeks.
You were so kind to come, Professor.
And this must be the fortunate young man you ought to marry.
John Harker, Professor.
Look here, Professor. I'm not going to get in your way, but if Dr. Seward will have me, I'm going to make him give me a bed here until Lucy gets over this thing. It's absolute hell being away in London. Of course, I can't get any work done.
Of course, you're most welcome to stay, my boy.
Oh, indeed, yes. I should have asked you to stay. I may need you. Now, lie back, so. And now, tell me, when did this weakness first come upon you?
2 nights after poor Mina was buried, I had a bad dream.
A bad dream? Tell me about it.
I remember hearing dogs barking before I went to sleep. The air seemed oppressive. I left the reading lamp lit by my bed. But when the dream came, there seemed to come a mist in the room.
Was the window open?
Yes, I always sleep with my window open.
Oh, of course, you're English. We Continentals are not so particular about fresh air. And then...
The mist seemed so thick, I could just see the lamp by my bed. A tiny spark in the fog. And then... I saw 2 red eyes staring at me, and a livid white face looking down at me out of the mist. It was horrible, horrible.
Go on, please.
The next morning, my maid could scarcely wake me. I felt weak and languid. Some part of my life seemed to have gone from me.
And there have been other such things?
Oh, nearly every night since then has come the mist. The red eyes and that awful face.
Tried transfusion twice. Each time she recovered her strength.
Yeah, but then would come another dream, and now I dread the night. And I know it seems absurd, Professor, but please don't laugh at me.
Oh, I am not likely to laugh. Yeah, let's see. No, it's all right. It's all right. How long have you had these little marks on your throat?
Since that first morning.
Lucy, why didn't you tell us?
Lucy, you've worn that scarf around your throat to hide
them. No, do not press her. Do not excite her. Well?
I was afraid they'd worry you, for I knew that Mina had them.
Quite right, Miss Lucy. Quite right. They're nothing. And Van Helsing will see that these dreams trouble you no more.
Count Dracula.
Ah, good evening, Count.
Gentlemen. Miss Sue, how are you? You are looking more yourself this evening.
I feel better already, Count, now that Father's old friend has come to help me.
Count Dracula, Professor Van Helsing.
A most distinguished scientist, whose name we know even in the wilds of Transylvania. But I interrupt a consultation.
Oh, not at all, Count. It's good of you to come, and we appreciate your motives.
Dr. Seward has just told me of your offer, and I can't thank you enough.
It is nothing. I should be grateful to be permitted to help Miss Lucy in any way.
But you do count. I look forward to your visits. They seem to make me better.
And so I arrived to find a rival in the field.
You encourage me, Miss Seward, to make them more frequent, as I should like to.
I'm always glad to see you.
Ah, but you have been lonely here. And my efforts to amuse you with our old tales will no longer have the same success now that you have Professor Van Helsing with you. And especially now that Mr. Harker is to remain here. How did you know I was going to stay, Count? Can the gallant lover ask such a question? I inferred it, my friend.
You're right. Nothing is going to shift me until Lucy's well again.
Nothing.
Please, come as before, Count. Won't you?
You understand, you will not answer bells. She must not be left alone for a moment under any circumstances, you understand?
Yes, sir.
Good. Your maid will take you to your room now. Try to rest for a little.
Wells, remember, don't leave her alone for a moment.
One, sir.
Professor Van Helsing, so you have come from the land of the tulip to cure the nervous prostration of this charming girl. I wish you all the success.
Thank you, Count.
Dr. Seward, I hope I do not appear officious. I am a lonely man. You are my only neighbors when I am here at Carfax, and your trouble has touched me greatly.
Count, I am more grateful for your sympathy than I can say.
You, like myself, are a stranger in England, Count.
Yes, but I love England. And the great London, so different from my own Transylvania, where there are so few people and so little opportunity.
Opportunity.
For my investigations, Professor.
I hope you haven't regretted buying that old ruin cross there.
Oh, Carfax is not a ruin. The dust was somewhat deep, but we are used to dust in Transylvania.
You plan to remain in England, Count?
I think so, my friend. The walls of my castle are broken and the shadows are many. And I am the last of my race.
It's a lonely spot you've chosen, Carfax.
It is. But when I hear the dogs howling far and near, I think myself back in my castle Dracula with its broken battlements.
The dogs there howl when wolves are around, don't they?
They do, my friend. And they howl here as well, although there are no wolves. The wolves. They are the children of the night. But you wish to consult the anxious father and the great specialist. May I read a book in the library? I am anxious to hear what the professor says, and to learn if I can be of any help.
By all means, Count. Would you like a glass of wine to take with you?
Thank you. No, I do not drink wine.
Very kind of Dracula with his untimely friendliness. But come now, Professor, what about my daughter?
Yes, Professor, what do you think is the matter with Lucy?
You know, that patient of yours, that interesting Renfield, does not like the smell of wolf's mane.
Good heavens, Professor, what does that have to do with my Lucy?
Perhaps nothing.
For God's sake, Professor. Is there anything unnatural or occult about this business?
A cult? Oh, my hell, Stephen.
Seward, may I remind you that the superstitions of today are the scientific facts of tomorrow. Science will soon be able to transmute the electron, the basis of all matter, into energy. And what is that? But the dematerialization of matter. And yet dematerialization has been known and practiced in India for centuries, in Java. I myself have seen things.
My dear friend, you can't have filled up your fine old brains with Eastern moonshine.
Moonshine?
But come now, what about my daughter?
Seward, if you won't listen to what will be harder to believe than any Eastern moonshine, if you won't forget your textbooks. Keep an open mind then, Seward. Your daughter's life may pay for your pig-headedness.
Go on, Professor.
I'm listening.
Then I will ask you to listen calmly for what I'm going to say. Sit down. You both have heard about the legends of Central Europe about the werewolf, the vampires.
You mean
ghosts who suck the blood of the living?
If you wish to call them ghosts, I call them the undead.
My God, man! Are you suggesting that Nina and now Lucy?
Van Helsing, of course I have read these horrible folk tales of the Middle Ages, but I know you better than to suppose it.
Then I believe them. I do believe them.
You mean vampires actually exist? And that Nina and Lucy have been attacked by one?
Oh, you know, your English doctors would laugh at such a theory, or your police, your public would laugh. The strength of the vampire is that people will not believe in him.
Is this the help you bring us?
Do not despise it.
Doctor, this case has stumped all your specialists. Go on, Professor.
Vampires are rare. Nature abhors them. The forces of good combine to destroy them, but a few of these creatures haven't lived on for centuries.
What is a vampire?
A vampire, my friend, is a man or a woman who is dead and yet not dead. A thing that lives after its death by drinking the blood of the living. It must have blood or it dies. Its power lasts only from sunset to sunrise, and during the hours of the day it must rest in the earth in which it was buried, but during the hours of the night, it has the power to prey upon the living. My friend, you must be thinking I'll have to put me amongst your patients.
I don't know what to think, Van Helsing, but I confess I simply cannot follow you.
What makes you think Lucy has been attacked by such a creature?
Well, Dr. Seward's written accounts of these ladies' symptoms at once aroused my suspicion. Anemia. The blood of three men was forced into the veins of Miss Mina, and yet she died from loss of blood. Where did it go? Had your specialist any answer? The vampire attacks the throat. He leaves two small wounds, white with red center. Seward, you told me of those marks on Miss Mina's throat. An accident with a safety pin, you said. So I thought, I suspected, I did not know, but I came on the instant, and what do I find? Those same marks on Miss Lucy's throat. Another safety pin, Dr. Seward.
You mean to tell us that you've built up all this nightmare out of a safety pin? It's true, I can't make out why she hid those marks from us.
Oh, I could tell you that.
What? I don't believe it. Lucy's trouble can't be that.
I do believe it. This theory accounts for all the facts that nobody's been able to explain. We must get Lucy away where this thing can't get at her.
You know, she will not want to go.
What?
If you force her, the shot may be fatal.
But why won't she go if we tell her life depends on it?
Because the victim of the vampire becomes his creature, linked to him in life and after death.
Oh, Van Helsing! This is too much!
Lucy? Become an unclean thing? A demon?
Yes, Harker. Now will you help me?
Yes. Anything. Tell me what to do.
It is dangerous work. Our lives are at stake. So is Miss Lucy's life, so is her soul. We must stamp out this monster.
How can we stamp it out now?
This undead thing lies helpless by day in the earth or the tomb in which it was buried.
The corpse. In a coffin.
A corpse, if you like, but a living corpse, sustained by the blood of the living. If we can find its hurt home, a stake driven through the heart destroys the vampire. But this is our task. In such a case, the police, the powers of society, are as helpless as the doctors. What bars or chains can hold a creature who can turn into a wolf or a bat?
A wolf? Dr. Seward, those dogs howling! I told you they howl that way in Russia when wolves are about. And a bat! Renfield said there was a bat!
Well, what of it?
Your friend Renfield does not like the smell of wolfsbane.
What in the world has your wolfsbane to do with any of this?
Vampires cannot stand the smell of wolfsbane.
You suspect that lunatic?
I suspect no one and everyone. Tell me, who is this Count Dracula?
Dracula? We really know very little about him.
When I was in Transylvania, I heard of Castle Dracula, a famous voivode Dracula who fought the Turks and lived there centuries ago.
I will make inquiries by telegraph. No, but after all, this thing must be English or at least have died here. His lair must be close enough for him to get back there before sunrise. My friends, I have only the old beliefs with which to fight this monster that has the strength of 20 men and perhaps the accumulated wisdom and cunning of centuries.
This all seems such a nightmare. Well, I'm with you, Professor.
And you, Dr. Silver.
It all seems preposterous to me. But everyone else has failed. The case is yours at present.
I need allies, not neutrals.
Very well. Do what you will.
Good, then bring your daughter here.
Well, what are you going to do?
To set a trap, Miss Lucy is the bait.
My God, we can't let you do that.
There's no other way. I believe this thing knows I will protect her. And that will put it on its guard. The very first moment she is alone, it will try to get at her because a vampire must have blood or its life and death ceases.
No, I forbid this.
John, she's my daughter, and I consent. We'll show the professor he's mistaken.
You only allow it because you don't believe. But I do believe. My God, Doctor, I've heard that lunatic laugh. Life-eating, you said he was. And you subject Lucy to that risk.
I must be master here, or I can do nothing. I must know in what form this thing comes before I can plan how to stamp it out. Bring your daughter here.
Jesus! Beg pardon, sir. Is Dr. Seward here?
What do you want with him?
Flycatch has escaped again, sir.
Escaped how?
Out the window, sir. The door was locked, and I was in the corridor all the while. And it's a drop of 30 feet to the stone flagging. That loony's a blooming flying squirrel, he is.
Say nothing to Dr. Seward at present. Nothing to hear. Now go.
Going to be all right, Lucy.
No, no!
You have nothing to fear, Lucy.
I just want you to lie down here, my dear.
Oh, but doctor...
You trust me, do you not? I just want you to lie here and live.
But I'm so frightened.
Make your mind passive. Try not to sink. Sleep if you can.
No, I dare not sleep. It is when I sleep.
I know, my dear, I know. I am going to cure you with God's help.
Oh, but Father!
You must do as Professor Van Helsing says. Come.
Come, Harker.
Better, I hope. Animal?
was a little white mouse, sir.
You mustn't scream. Not in this house, now.
I'm sorry, sir. It was a nasty little beast.
You'll alarm Miss Lucy. She's already dreadfully upset as it is by something in the paper.
Oh, do you mean about the Hampstead Horror, sir? The lady in white who gives chocolates to little children.
Never mind that, but I will not have Miss Lucy disturbed.
Forgive me, my footfall is not heavy and your rugs are soft.
It's all right, sir. But how did you come in?
The door of this room was ajar, so I did not knock. How is Miss Lucy and her nervous prostration?
I think she's better, sir.
Ah, good. But the strain of Miss Lucy's illness has made you also ill.
How did you know, sir? Oh, but it's just a pain in my head that runs down into the neck.
I can remove this pain.
I don't understand, sir.
Such pains yield readily to sedation.
Excuse me, sir, but if it's hypnotism you mean, I'd rather have the pain.
You think of hypnotism as an ugly waving of arms in many passes. That is not my method. What is given can be taken away. From now on, you have no pain, and you have no will of your own. Do you hear me?
I hear you.
When you awake, you will not remember what I say. Dr. Seward ordered you today to sleep with your mistress every night in the same bed because of her bad dreams. Is it not so?
Yes, master.
Your mistress threatened by horror and by death, but I will save her. A man whose will is at cross purposes with mine has come to this house. I will crush him. Receive your orders, you hear me?
Yes, master.
Hear and obey. From now on, you will carry out any suggestion that reaches you from my brain instantly without question. When I will you to do a thing, it shall be done. My call will reach you soon.
Mistress alone?
Dr. Seward is with her, sir.
What's wrong with you, my girl?
Nothing, sir.
You just had a severe shock.
It's nothing, sir. I suddenly felt queer, that's all. I can't remember anything.
Mr. Hawk has just arrived. Asked Dr. Seward to come here and report with Miss Lucy yourself.
Yes, sir. She's dreadfully upset, sir.
Upset? Over what?
It's in the evening paper, sir. About the Hampstead Horror. Sir.
Oh, my God, she has seen it.
Everything just the same. Whenever I leave this house, even for a few hours, I dread what I may find when I come back.
And well you may, my friend.
God must have sent you here to help us. Without you, there'd be no hope. And this morning, Professor, when you opened your veins to revive Lucy again?
It was the least I could do. It was my lack of foresight that was responsible for this attack.
Don't say that.
The maid slept with her, and yet we found the wolf's bane thrown off the bed to the floor.
She was so weak, so pale. The two little wounds opened fresh again.
Well, I have prepared a stronger defense. But our main task is not defense, but attack. What have you learned in London?
A lot, but heaven knows what it means or whether it's any use.
Yeah, I too have had news of which I can make nothing.
Ah, John, back from town.
Yes.
We must piece together what we have learned today. My colleague in Bucharest wires that the Dracula family has been extinct for 500 years.
Can the Count be an imposter?
The castle he calls his own is a desolate ruin near the border. It was built, as you said, Harker, by the terrible voivode Dracula, who is said to have had dealings with evil spirits. He was the last of his race. But for many generations, the peasants have believed the castle Dracula inhabited by a vampire.
But it must be him!
My friends, I am bewildered.
But surely this confirms your suspicion. I was incredulous, but now... No,
a vampire from Transylvania cannot be in England.
But why?
Because, as I have told you, the vampire must rest by day in the earth in which the corpse it inhabits was buried.
In the earth?
The vampire must return to its burial place by sunrise.
I found today that Dracula arrived at the Croydon Aerodrome on March 6th in a three-engine German plane.
March 6th? 3 days before Mina first fell ill.
The plane had made a non-stop flight from Sicily in Transylvania. It arrived, it left just after sunset, it arrived 2 hours before dawn, and it carried only the Count and 6 packing cases.
Have you learned what was in those cases?
He told the customs people he wanted to see whether Transylvania plants would grow in a foreign climate in their native soil.
Soil? What was in those boxes?
Just plain dirt. He left in a lorry with the 6 coffin-like boxes before sunrise.
Oh my God, yes. Before sunrise! The king of vampires, my friends, this creature is the terrible voivode Dracula himself. It is satanic pride and contempt. He uses his own name. For who would suspect for 500 years he has been fettered to his castle because he must sleep by day in his graveyard? 5 centuries pass. The airplane is invented. His chance has come. For now he can cross Europe in a single night. He prepared 6 coffins filled with the earth in which he must rest by day. He leaves his castle after sunset. By dawn, he is in London and safe in one of his cases. A great risk, but he has triumphed. He has reached London with its teeming millions, with its opportunity, as he said.
God protect my Lucy.
I saw the estate agent from whom we bought Carfax here and got the addresses of 4 old houses he has leased in different parts of London.
One of his coffin retreats is in each of those houses.
The 2 heavy boxes were delivered at Carfax the day after he took possession.
He has scattered them for safety. If we can find all 6, we can destroy them.
But how?
His native earth will not receive his unclean form if each box is sanctified with holy water.
Then we must get at those boxes. Tear them open one by one. If we find him, then in God's name, Professor, let it be my hand that shall drive a stake through this devil's heart and send his soul to hell.
Your plan is too dangerous.
But why? These attacks on Lucy continue. Are we to delay while my child is dying?
No, not for a moment.
Be patient, my friends. This creature is more than mortal. His cunning is the growth of the ages. What if we find 5 of the boxes, close them against him, and cannot find the 6th?
Well?
Then he will bury himself in his last refuge where we can never find him. And sleep until we are all dead.
Then Lucy will be safe.
In her life, yes. But his unclean kisses claim to find his own. When she dies, she will become as he is, a foul thing of the night. The vampire can wait. No, there's only one way to save her from him, to destroy him.
You're right. As always.
We have one great advantage. By day, he is a corpse and can know nothing of our search if we leave no traces.
God, this delay!
We must make the round of all his houses, find all 6 boxes without his knowledge, and then we act.
What about the caretakers and servants?
All the houses would be empty. The vampire plays a lone hand.
Renfield!
He's been here all the time we've been talking.
Did you hear what we were saying, man?
Yes, I heard something. Enough. Be guided by what he says. It is your only hope. It is her only hope. It is my only hope. Save my soul, please. Save my soul. I am weak. You are strong. I am crazy. You are sane. You are good and he is evil.
I will save you, Renfield, but you must tell us everything you know. Everything.
No. What should I know?
I don't know anything.
You say I'm mad.
I'll have them taken away.
Fool! And I thought you were wise. The whole world is mad just now, and if you want help, you must come to a madman together. But I won't give it to you, I'm afraid. A wise madman will obey him who is strong, and not the weak.
Him? Whom do you mean?
Oh, you do mention friends. Names among friends. Come, Professor. Be reasonable. What have I got to gain by being on your side? The doctor keeps me shut up all day.
And if I'm good, he gives me a little sugar to spread out for my flies.
But on the other hand, if I serve him...
The blood is the life, eh, Renfield? What have you to do with Count Dracula?
Dracula? I never even heard the name before.
Well, you are lying.
Madmen, Professor, lack the power to discriminate between truth and falsehood. So I pay no attention to what anybody would say, any man would say. Send me away. I asked you to before, and you wouldn't. If you only knew what has happened since then, I dare not tell you more. I would die in torment if I betrayed
you. Dr. Schuman will send you away if you speak. Yes, Renfield. I offer you your soul in exchange for what you know.
God will not damn a poor lunatic soul. God knows the devil is too strong for us. We have weak minds. But why are they asking you to send me away, Dr. Schuman? Please, promise to send me away.
If you will speak. Come, Renfield.
And I will tell you, Count Dracula is master. No. I didn't say anything. I told them nothing. I am your slave. I'm loyal to you.
Don't let it inside. A bat flying in a circle. What's that? Just passing that small shrub.
Looks like a big gray dog.
You sure it's a dog?
Well, it could easily be a wolf.
Oh, but that's nonsense. Our nerves are making us see things. Come, Renfield, what were you about to say?
Nothing.
I said nothing!
Professor, have you seen what
give
this?
That to me.
Are you my steward?
I am.
In the name of the merciful and compassionate God, leave this place at once.
But this is my home. Nothing would induce me to leave.
Oh, that's true. You wouldn't go if they tried to drag you away. It's too late. The fool I am. I should punish you, they say. I can't do any good. It's too late. You are so young, so beautiful, so pure. Even I have decent feelings sometimes. But I must tell you, if you don't go, your soul will pay for it. You're in the power of... The master is at hand!
Butterworth!
Goodbye, Mr. Sword. Since you will not heed my warnings, I pray God I may never see your face again!
What did he mean? What did he mean? Why did he say that?
Lucy! That crazy thing in league with the devil. Horrible. And Lucy already upset as it is by something in the paper.
Go in and get that paper from her.
Whatever it is, she keeps reading the same article again and again.
Take it away from her, man, and come back to me.
Don't overdo it, Van Helsing. God knows where we would be without you. After transfusion, you really ought to be in bed at your age. The loss of so much blood is serious.
I never felt so fit in my life.
I only ask you not to overestimate your strength now when we lean on you. Feeling fit, are you? Take a look at yourself in the hand mirror.
Thank you. did not hear you, Count.
I am often told that I have a light footstep.
I was looking in the mirror. Its reflection covers the whole room. I can't...
Forgive me. I dislike mirrors. They are the playthings of man's vanity. And how is the fair patient?
The diagnosis presents difficulties.
I feared it might, my friend.
Would you like to see what I prescribe for my patient?
Anything that you prescribe for Miss Lucy has the greatest interest for me.
The prescription is a most unusual one.
The cut is not deep. I looked.
No, but it will serve. This is my actual medicine for Miss Lucy. You do not care for the smell?
You are a wise man, Professor. One who has not lived even a single lifetime.
You flatter me, Count.
Not wise enough to return to Holland at once, now that you have learned what you have learned.
I prefer to remain, even though a certain lunatic here threatened to kill me.
Lunatics are difficult. They do not do what they are told. They even try to betray their benefactors. But when servants fail to obey orders, the master must carry them out for himself.
I anticipated as much.
In the past 500 years, Professor, those who have crossed my path have all died, and some not presently. Come! Here! Strong, then I must come to you. More medicine, Professor.
More effective than wolfsbane, Count.
Indeed. Sacrilege!
I have a dispensation.
Sacrilege!
Humano tuos commendo, sir, in spirit for me! She knows.
But that would mean that Lucy is in collusion with the
future. That's impossible. No, no, Miss Lucy, you must not.
Lucy, what's in this paper that's upset you?
Read it.
No, Hawker, no.
Read it.
The Hampstead Horror. Further attacks on small children committed after dark by a mysterious and beautiful woman in Hampstead are reported today. Narratives of three small girls, all under 10 years of age, tally in essential details. Each child speaks of a beautiful lady in white who gave her chocolates, enticed her to some secluded corner, and there kissed and caressed her and bit her slightly in the throat.
Go on.
The wounds are trivial. The children suffered no other harm and do not seem to have been frightened. Indeed, one small girl told her mother she hoped she might see the beautiful lady again.
Oh, so soon. So soon. You know what's been happening, Lucy.
Professor Van Helsing knows too, Lucy, and he knows how to protect you.
Is it not too late?
It is not too late, Miss Lucy. These poor, innocent children. You'll take the Count?
Not that name.
You'll think that the werewolf has done this too?
Of course.
In a woman's form.
Who else could it be?
It is worse, far worse.
Worse? What do you mean?
Miss Lucy knows.
The woman in white is Mina.
Mina? But she's dead, Lucy.
She has joined the Master.
God protect us all. Miss Lucy, I will not ask you how you know, but after tonight, no more little children will meet the woman in white. She will remain at rest in the tomb where you laid her, and her soul, released from this horror, will be with God.
How can you do this?
Do not ask me.
Professor, if you can save Mina's soul after her death, can you save mine?
Lucy!
We'll save you. In God's name, I swear it. And he has given me a sign in this room tonight.
Then promise me one thing. Whatever you plan to do, whatever you know, do not tell me. Not even if I beg you to tell me, swear that you will not now, while I'm still yours. Promise it.
I promise it.
No. John, you mustn't kiss me. Promise that you never will, not even if I beg you to.
I promise.
My dear Miss Lucy, after tonight, one of us will be awake all night in this room, next to your bedroom, with the door open.
You're so good.
I will make this room safe for you. Your maid will be with you. Doctor, I want you to rub this above the window in the room there. You know, rub it around the sashes and especially above the lock. You see, I have made this wreath that you must wear tonight. While you wear this, those dreams cannot come to you. Swear to me that you will not take this off.
I promise.
Swear it on the cross.
I swear it.
Professor, surely the host is more powerful than this wolf's bane.
Of course.
Then why not leave the host with him? Nothing can harm her then.
The host cannot be used where there has been pollution. What is it?
It's Renfield, sir.
Why haven't you got it locked up?
Because he's barred himself in his room.
Oh.
He got hold of one of the patients, and he has it by the throat.
Ah, human blood now. Come, Arthur.
I'll be right back, Lucy.
I should have had him locked up.
John! John! Oh, don't you leave me, too.
Of course I won't listen, Lucy. It's nothing but a quarrel among the patients. Mr. Harker will be back soon. Oh, Miss Lucy. These evil smelling flowers have made you faint.
Thank you.
is it?
Anyone what wants my job, sir, can have it.
What's the matter?
I knows what I knows, and I seen what I saw. And I ops her by the first train. I take no wages in lieu of nuggets.
Where's Grinfield?
If you ask me, sir, he's probably taking a little visit to L.
Let him escape again?
Look here, sir. Having, so to speak, resigned, I don't have to take any more of this from any of you. A man, what a man can't do, he can't do. And that's that.
Can't you see, man, that Dr. Sewell is not well? You desert him, but he needs all the help he can get.
Putting it that way, sir, I'm not the kind of man to run under fire. But I'm sick and tired of being told off for something that ain't my fault.
We don't blame you. No boats or bars can hold Renfield.
Now you're talking sense, sir. This time I had him in a straitjacket. All day yesterday I spent crimping bars across the window. Now I find those bars, oh, the poor, like they're made of cheese and him gone.
Then try to find him.
Find him. I can't chase him up down the wall. I ain't no bloody mountain goat.
The thing mocks us. A few hours after he learns what we know and what we have done, he comes here and drags that creature of his to himself.
What can the vampire want with Renfield?
Renfield is serving an apprenticeship to join the vampire after he dies.
What does Renfield matter? If we are beaten, then there is no God.
Oh, dare not despair, Seward.
To know in advance what anyone would do who got on his track?
I thought we had him when we broke into Carfax, found two of the earth boxes, and then found one box in each of his other four houses, and then when I pried open the sixth box, I was sure we'd find him there, helpless.
Empty.
In an empty packing case, left as a blind.
Yes. Oh, it's not half an hour until sunrise. John, poor John, has been sitting up with Lucy for 9 hours. Soon it will be dawn, and she will be safe, and he can get some sleep, and anyone can sleep in this house.
Whoever else sleeps or doesn't sleep, Miss Lucy will sleep at dawn.
Another horror?
Oh, you noticed. How she stays awake all night now and sleeps by day?
Is that part of the change?
Of course, and then sometimes the look that comes into her face...
No, man, don't! For God's sakes, I can't bear it!
We must face it. For her sake.
To know how did he get at her with the wolfsbane and the cross around her neck? Suggestion conveyed from the monster?
Yes. He must have impelled the maid to take away the wolfsbane and the cross and open the window. I should have foreseen that.
Don't blame yourself. The devil is more cunning than we are. Yet Lucy seems better. Until this last attack, she was always exhausted. But last night at sunset, when she got up after sleeping all day...
There was blood in her cheeks.
Yes! Thank God!
Where do you think that blood came from, my friend?
What do you suggest
now?
What new horror?
It's not 5:30 in the morning. Strange hour for men who are crazy to be up and about.
We may get help from this thing that's still half-human. Renfield.
He's after you. He's going to kill me.
We'll save you, Renfield, but you must tell us what you know.
You? You poor puny man. You measure your brains against his. You have no idea what you're dealing with. You, a thick-headed Dutchman and a fool of an alienist. And that young cub of a boy, why? Not all the soldiers and police in London could stop the master from doing as he likes.
But God can stop him.
God permits evil. Why does he permit evil if he's good? Tell me that.
How did you escape through those iron bars?
Now I'd have a great strength, Doctor.
Come, Renfield, we know you didn't wrench those bars apart yourself.
No, I didn't. I wanted him there. I hope they'd keep him out. He did it and he came. Master is angry. He promised me eternal life and live things. Live things, big ones, not flies and spiders and blood. Always blood. I must obey him, but I don't want to. be like him. I'm mad. I know, and bad too, for I have taken lives. Without, they were only little lives. I'm not like him. I wouldn't want a human life.
Oh, John.
What did I seek to betray him for you? I said I'd serve the devil, but I didn't serve him honestly. I don't fight women with no blood in them. And yet I warned you and made him angry. Now, perhaps, he will kill me and I won't get any more live things to eat. No more blood to drink.
Your purity itself. You love her, and in love to her, it is truth. She is and this evil thing that has entered her shall be rooted out.
You said you could save Mina's soul.
Mina's soul is in heaven.
Tell me how.
It is your right to know. I entered her tomb. I opened her coffin. I saw her there sleeping, but not dead. Not truly dead. There was blood in her cheeks, a drop of blood like a red ruby on the corner of her mouth. With a stake and hammer, I struck to the heart. One scream, a convulsion, and then the look of peace that came over her face when, with God's help, I had made her truly dead.
If I die, swear to me that you will do this to my body.
It shall be done.
I swear it, and I.
Father, my lover, my dear friend, you've sworn to save my soul, and now I'm done with life.
No, Miss Lucy, by all that is sacred, you must not even think of suicide. That would put you in his power forever.
I cannot face this horror that I'm becoming.
We shall find this thing that has fouled your life, destroy him, and send his soul to hell, and it shall be by my hand.
You must destroy him, if you can, but with pity in your hearts, not rage and vengeance. That poor soul, who has done so much evil, needs our prayers more than any other.
No, you cannot ask me to forgive.
Perhaps I, too, will need your prayers and your pity.
My dear Miss Lucy, now while you are yourself, help me.
How can I help you? No, you mustn't tell me. You mustn't tell me anything.
Each time the white face and the red eyes came, you were pale, exhausted afterwards, but the last time...
The last time he came, he said I was his bride. He would seal me to him for the centuries to come.
And then?
And then? No, I can't tell you, I can't.
No, you must. You must, Lucy.
He scratched open one of his veins. He pressed my mouth down to it. He called it a sacrament. He made me drink. I can't.
I warned you, my friend. I came in when I heard the dogs howling.
The dogs! They're the werewolves about!
He is pursuing Renfield.
Ah, we must do something!
And at once. I shall leave Renfield here as I did Miss Lucy. And if the thing appears, we will bar the two doors in the window.
Bar? Against that?
Even against that, for we each shall carry the sacred element.
And then?
And then I do not know. For we do not know its full powers, but this I do know. It is 8 minutes till sunrise. The power of all evil things ceases. With the coming of day, this one last earth box is his only refuge. So if we can keep him here till daybreak, he must collapse. And then the stake and the hammer are ready. He's here. Come quickly.
It's Renfield!
No, man. And this may save your soul and your life as well.
No, come here.
Master, I didn't do it. I said nothing. I am your slave, your dog. Master, please don't kill me. For the love of God, let me live. Torture me. I deserve it. But let me live. I can't face God with all that. Those lives on my conscience, all that blood on my hands. And
did I not promise you that you should come to me at your death? And enjoy centuries of life and power over the bodies and souls of others.
Yes. I want life, I want blood. But I didn't want human life.
You betrayed me. You sought to warn my distant rhyme against
me. Mercy. Please don't kill me.
Combination will break through somehow. Quick, the hammer! seems an old vault.
Ah!
What is it? Where are you, man?
No, I'm sorry, I'm all right. Big rat ran over my foot.
Where are you?
What is this place?
You can't see very well.
It smells horribly. Bats.
That's an animal smell, like the lair of a wolf.
That's what it is.
There's absolutely nothing here.
Here's another passage.
I knew it. That must go to Carfax. The sixth earth box is hidden somewhere here.
And the monster is in it.
You can't be sure.
Vampire!
Where is he?
All over there somewhere. But just because Renfield's here doesn't mean the vampire knows about this place.
It's the vampire's life or yours.
I know nothing. Let me go.
Look at him, man. Look at him. He knows. Here it is. We must get the lid open.
Yeah.